According to this report, much of this might have been prevented. When Ferdinand Risco was brought on here at TARC in 2017, nobody bothered to check with his former employer.
There's some things in that report that are heinous, ugly. But the reality is the entire truth needs to be made access to the public.
The report details allegations by 12 victims against TARC's former executive director, Ferdinand Risco. According to the report, Risco embarked on a pattern of behavior that can best be described as that of a sexual predator.
The goal of this is to try to prevent something like this from ever happening again.
Brent Ackerson is the head of the Government Oversight Committee, which will hold a hearing on the report on June 1st.
This was preventable on the front end had some people done their due diligence. Plain and simple. The ball was dropped from the get-go. And we wouldn't be in this boat had people just taken some time to do a little vetting.
Investigators found TARC never contacted Risco's former employer, Atlanta's public transit system known as MARTA. If TARC had made the call, they might have discovered something disturbing. According to the report, 8 MARTA employees who knew or worked with Risco were interviewed. Many recounted troubling behavior by Risco exceedingly similar to that reported by TARC victims.
I mean, for one person to have committed so many acts against so many different people over such an extensive period of time says that the system failed.
A spokesperson for TARC said they could not comment on the report, but the company has said it has enacted changes to prevent sexual harassment in the future and create more oversight.
The question will be is what we glean from this very extensive report, if there's some changes that we need to implement. And I think there probably will be. There should be.
Mark Vanderhoff, WLKY News.